Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my channel, Red Elevator. I am Nina Takesh. I am stepping out of the red elevator in case you guys are new to the channel. I have a red elevator at home and I bring you beautiful content that you can use to embellish your home. And today, one of these topics is going to be how to design your foyer. A lot of people ask me about how to design their entrances, and that is exactly what we're going to be looking at today. So follow me. As many of you ask, I will be pointing out what I am wearing today. And as you know, I love to collect beautiful pieces as I do beautiful vintage clothes. My outfit is from Avero Bessardi, which is an Italian designer, which I got from The Real Real. I will link dresses similar to this below in the description box. And my shoes are Bottega. A plethora of you have asked how to design your home entrances, and I'm here to tell you exactly what to do. A foyer is actually a French term, which is basically a term where actors would stand and wait in a holding area before going onto stage. So it is now, of course, a term that refers to an opening, an entrance into either a building or a residence. Many of you have seen my foyer in other YouTube videos on my channel. And if you're new, I'm gonna ask you please to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. That is really, really helpful. Now, this foyer has been featured on my channel before. And as I've told you guys, it is a very important room because it sets the tone for the rest of the house. A foyer should be a place that is a little bit different than the rest of the house because you want it to pop. And as you can see in my own entrance, I have a beautiful piano, I'll have a pop of art, I do change things around, and at the moment I've got these two beautiful sculptures that are to the right and to the left of my entrance. These might change depending on my mood. And also my center console table. This table is a very important table as it is the first piece of furniture you see when you are greeted into this space. I use this table for many different reasons and it does change throughout the season. For example, during the holidays, I intend to completely change the entrance of my home and I do make it more Christmas-like. As you can see from this older footage, last Christmas I had an entire collection of holiday items placed on the center table so that my guests were greeted and the kids could have a little bit of fun looking at the different reindeer, looking at the different Christmas ornaments, and really bringing the festivities into the home. Take a look at this particular foyer. This is Ricky Martin's Beverly Hills house right here close by. And what I love about this foyer is that it is a space that is actually very much quaint and small. And many of us don't have the capacity to have large foyers. And if you were to have a small space like this one, look at how the art and the table and the sculptural glass vase and the lamp play together to create a very impactful space. The art is by Kawasaje and the lamp is also very sculptural, mid-century piece by Schoolhouse Electric. The very next image I wanted to share with you is small and also very impactful. This is a left bank apartment designed by my absolute favorite interior designer, Jean-Louis Degnaud, in Paris. And the diamond patterns on the floor are reminiscent of my own. These are very classic patterns that exist and are timeless. If you want to do something timeless, this is your floor. Also, what's really beautiful about this room, again, this is an American couple that lives in France. They really embraced the culture and brought in this beautiful Louis XVI chair upholstered in leather, which gives it that edge. And don't forget that you can also bring in curtains. Velvet curtains adorn this gorgeous foyer and really give it that interesting French cultural beautiful vibe. By the way, all of these entrances and foyers that I'm recommending to you, I would like you to use them as inspiration for your own homes. If you see a space that resembles yours, take elements and parts of that foyer and apply it to yourself. If you have a small entrance, do an architectural table with a large scale artwork above it. Put one lamp, put one sculptural artwork. I've done a lot of expert sessions with people who have called me, and that is one of the things that I really recommend. If you want to have a 50-minute session or a 25-minute session, you can definitely book me on The Expert. It'll be linked in the box, description box below, so that if you need a virtual consultation regarding any space in your home, you can get it done and I will show up on the Zoom. The next space is a wonderful example of those that are not shy to think outside of the box and to push the design envelope. I particularly love this space. This is a house that was designed by Kelly Wurzler. As you can tell her style. And it has a mix of beautiful vintage and new pieces. The floors are a sunburst pattern of onyx and marble that have been cut and laid to create that pattern. So that is a very intricate pattern, but it can be done easily if you've got a good fabricator and you can create a beautiful pattern with stone. The sunburst chandelier above the center table is a beautiful piece by Jean de Mairie, and there are lots of pieces that actually look like that and knockoffs of that. So if you like that look, you can certainly find it. Just make sure and Google sunburst. The round table is very fun because it is essentially hands and feet that are holding glass. This is a piece by the very well-known South American artist Pedro Friedberg, and they go for thousands of dollars on first dibs, but I believe you can certainly find a piece that is interesting to put in your foyer. Make it a talking piece, make it different, make it stand out. Notice a giant sculpture at the end of the hallway. That brings a lot of intrigue into the space. I always say bring different objects into a space, different heights, different scale, and different proportions to balance out all of the visual intrigue. The next entrance is a Southampton home designed by David Netto. And this is actually a great example for those of you who have more of a traditional or country home. These have a beautiful horse door, double opening door, which is really fun and done purposefully, along with a large basket that you see on the floor from Meacocks. You would never expect to see a large basket in a foyer, but notice how this really works. The pendant light is from Charles Edwards, and it's a beautiful cobalt blue, which is really nice against some of the different accent colors you see in the room. Don't be afraid of color if you've got pops of it that are balanced out. The next very interesting detail that I wanted to point out about this particular entrance is that you've got wallpaper panels on the doors. These are what look like libraries, but in fact, they're just simple wallpaper, a very inexpensive way to bring a lot of visual interest into your room. If you were not familiar with Naomi Watts' Manhattan duplex, you are now. Look at this gorgeous, beautiful entrance. The floors, as you can see, are geometric patterns that are really fun and are at a diagonal. Those tiles are actually by Klee, spelled C-L-E. And what is really astounding about this entrance is the opening steel rounded doors. These doors are expensive, but there is a lot of interest when you are greeted by such a beautiful, astounding steel door. Lastly, the peekaboo of the staircase, which is rounded, is really beautiful with that pop of red like I have in my own foyer, is really a gorgeous statement. The next really fun idea that I recommend you guys do for those of you who are out of ideas for your foyer is literally what you see here. You have a Louis XV commode, which you could buy at any estate sale. And above it, you have a gallery of mirrors. Go to an estate sale, go onto eBay, go to all sorts of other resale sites and find old vintage mirrors. They are not expensive. Find a collection of them and put them above a commode or a table. This is something that's easy and very impactful. If you're not following me on Instagram, I highly suggest that you do. My handle is right here, at Nina Takesh, and I share a lot of interior design secrets, sources, everything that you want, either in my stories and also on my feed. The very last foyer that I wanted to share with you today is from a Paris beautiful townhome that has Turkish cream smooth floors with a black border. This allows the space to feel like as if there was a carpet on the floor, even though, of course, there isn't one. What really drew me to this space was the fact that the staircase did not have railings. I understand we can't do that because it's just not safe, but just the fact that you could see this was really intriguing and I wanted to share it with you. But outside of the fact that we can't mimic the staircase without rails, I did love the pop of red again with these gorgeous 19th century chairs that are spread throughout the entrance. As you can also see, there are bronze sculptures of fawns that are sporadically placed in this room as well. What works in this room is the fact that we have very interesting pieces that we wouldn't expect. A sculptural garden bronze statue of a fawn next to a 19th century chair. Why not? Think outside the box, let your imagination roll, and you will definitely create something that is very gossip worthy. Thank you for joining me on this very fun episode of Red Elevator, how to decorate your entrances. My best takeaway from this video is to truly find unique pieces. I hate seeing my beautiful followers just mimic what's in a catalog. I think it's very boring and it saddens my heart. So think outside the box, find unique pieces, don't be afraid, mix it up, and have a great week, because we'll see you again here next week on another very exciting episode of The Red Elevator. Have a good one.